How in the world do you top what we did yesterday?
I have no freaking idea. I mean, we had like how many people on the show via Skype? We had two on Skype. We had two extra people on the show. We can't top it.
It was a technological achievement to say the
least. That
was
not planned at all. We did not plan that. And luckily, I think like Ariel had stuff in his pockets to save us. No, it was Justin.
Well, no.
He had stuff in his pockets.
Oh, Justin had something in his pocket that actually wound up saving us. But give it up for Ariel, who like we made it all work in the last second.
Yeah, we were about to have to cancel it because we were having technical difficulties and all of a sudden everything worked.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The power went out in here.
Yeah.
So like none of the lights were working. The TV wasn't working. We were effed hard. Mm-hmm. But then we got un-effed.
Some kind of miracle happened.
By some sort of divine intervention, the podcast gods let us do our thing. It's amazing. That's why I'm a religious man.
I'm sure somebody like unplugged like a washer or dryer that was hooked up to the same breaker to this thing.
No, just the building engineers like flipped the breaker. That's
yeah,
it.
I was looking. Yeah. Did say what? 15 amps for a studio?
Yeah, no. We're not going to get into the technical stuff like that. But
not a good idea. Even
amazing. I just want to like let everyone know how close we were to not doing it yesterday. Speaking of yesterday, holy moly! Go back and watch it. It sounds like people really were happy. Right? Everyone's like in a celebratory mood. It was the most viewed Facebook story we ever did. It got 14,000 Facebook
views. Yeah, I saw that blowing up. That was freaking awesome.
Yeah.
It was a huge episode. It was awesome to be part of that.
This is huge.
Yeah.
Huge.
So we got nothing today.
No, today.
Oh, wait.
Today we have the meat sweeps.
What?
Meat sweeps.
Define meat sweeps.
Today we have the meat sweeps. Mm. Remember? Right. Yes. That's the perfect sound effect. So what? Going back to Monday or last week, I'm like, guess the contest sponsor. Guess the contest partner.
Mm-hmm.
And who did you guess?
Omaha Steaks.
Well, guess what? You were right.
That is complete bullshit. Okay, so yesterday, so I was thinking about this. Like, when you asked me this question, it was like Ghostbusters. I'm like, what is like the one thing that we would never, ever have? It's like, this is the thing that I'm like, I used to watch QVC a lot when I was a kid, and they'd have meats for sale, like, yeah, through the mail, and I'm like, you're kidding me.
Yeah.
That's impossible. How does that work?
Yep.
Never had a steak through the mail. So I'm like, sure, Omaha Steaks, because that's crazy.
It's not crazy. Have you ever had Omaha Steaks, by the way?
No, I haven't.
I had them in college. It's fantastic. Just because you get meat in the mail and it feels like you shouldn't get meat in the mail, but getting it in the mail is great.
Yeah, that sounds like a part of the appeal.
Yeah, well, that's the appeal. The contest is going to start next week, so stay tuned to our Twitter feed and the show.
And you're serious, right?
I'm not joking. We're giving away two mega like prizes, like mega giveaways. I'm not. You think I'm joking?
Well, because it's the thing I picked was ridiculous. And you've somehow managed to make that a reality. I'm sure we had something else lined up, like a whole brand new like Ferrari for somebody. Like, you know what I'm going to do? This prank is going too far, I think, Bacalar.
It's not. It's real.
You should
real.
Freaking tell me the truth already.
We're giving away. It's called the Tasteful Gift. I'm not joking.
That's clever.
It's tasty.
Ha, 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 ha.
Dude, I'm not going to get into the specific details, but it's got fillets, sirloins, burgers, baked potatoes, and freaking molten lava cakes.
When does this thing start?
So you can't win.
I know can't win. I know of all the things that I want to have in the world.
It's gonna start next week, and we're going to do a cool sort of different way to give it away. We're going to do a caption contest. So all that will be made available next week. So tune into the show next week. And the contest is only going to last a week, and you'll have a chance to win. It's going to be a lot of fun. We've never done a caption contest before. I don't know why, but we're going to start next week with Omaha Steaks. All right, let's get into the show, ladies and gentlemen. It's Friday, December 5th, 2014. Let's start. I'm a medium rare guy. How do you like yours cooked? Medium rare?
I didn't know I liked medium rare until I actually got medium rare done right.
Right.
And I was like, oh, what is this? They're like, this is medium rare. I'm like, this is what I like.
This is the future of steak.
This should be.
Ariel?
Medium rare.
Medium rare.
As well, yep.
Because once you, I got friends who do like well, and I'm just like,
no.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah.
I grew up on well done. My folks always order our steaks well done, and I got one that was slightly underdone.
What are you, a pregnant lady?
Not that I knew
of. I only
of.
Know that now for
yeah,
personal
it's a
reasons.
Concern.
Yeah.
Yeah. As you are pregnant yourself.
As I am pregnant. I'm showing.
You're with child right yeah. now. Yeah. They accidentally undercooked it. I'm like, this is awesome. My mom's like, put that down. I'm like, no. Yeah. I'm going to get this. This is medium. I went down.
I have a friend who who's clearly unstable and gets black and blue. Do you know what that is?
Is that like charred on the outside and it's like just frozen on the inside?
No, it's like 2 minutes on each side. Serve it up.
That's kind of what I just said.
No, but it's like gross. I don't think it's charred at all because two minutes isn't enough time.
On the outside, you got that cold, black and blue.
Very cold on the inside.
Does not sound appealing.
It's like, you know, when you watch like cartoons and they would give like a lion a piece of meat and it's just like a slab of red with white in the middle. That's like what you're eating. You know what I'm talking about?
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Little cartoon slab of meat.
The one that's like a toy treat for dogs.
Yeah, too. Yeah, it's in the shape of like a heart a little bit. Ridiculous. Yes. Right?
So
absolutely
gross.
Ridiculous. So that's how he eats it. We'll get more into the meat sweeps. I will say meat sweeps. Forever next week when we start that. So real quick, what I wanted to do is I wanted to show off something I got in the mail today that I am very excited about.
These are not steaks.
You cannot eat them. They come from a company called Evil Controllers. You can buy these, I believe, in Best Buy. But I had these guys reached out and I had them make some custom Xbox One and PlayStation 4 Ooh-wee. Controllers. Look at that.
We designed this online. They're not doing that justice. The color is like
it's like hunting vest orange.
Yeah, you're not going to get shot if you're playing in that with that.
But how tight is that? Now, this is the Xbox One version, and you can customize every last possible doodad. I customized the bumpers. Even the LED light in the middle here is like, I think it glows orange. Custom analog sticks, custom back. Look at it, all right? Come on. Play around with that and don't tell me it's...
This is really nice looking.
The coolest thing you ever seen, right?
I like the silver on the...
Silver's tight. Mm-hmm. So you can check them out. Evil Controllers is the company name. I'm going to also post a little write-up and a gallery. Now, here's the green PlayStation 4 controller.
Nice.
But wait, it gets cooler. I don't know if you could see this. Can you make out what that says on the back there? That says my name on it.
Ooh-wee.
I've reached a new level of nerddom.
That's
great. I have ascended to the top level.
In case you have like a marathon session, you forget who you are. You're like,
oh my God. Oh, okay. This is right. How cool is that though?
That is
it's a little heavier than normal, but it's nice, right?
Yeah, it's got a nice weight. Heavy. Yeah, but these are ridiculous.
They're amazing.
They're beautiful.
They're a little expensive, but I think if you're a hardcore gamer,
only the best.
Maybe you want to treat yourself to something nice this holiday season.
Treat yourself.
And I don't know. I'm trying to, maybe we can like work out like a code with these guys or something to give away. That would be lovely.
What would you name this? Sweeps?
No, I don't know. That wouldn't be a sweeps thing. I'm done with the sweeps for now. Too many lawyers. We'll leave them here to show for the rest of the program. Okay, let's get into some of the news of the day. My father would love this first story because it's all about how the humble flip phone is making a return.
Yeah, I overheard this morning in the office. Somebody was talking about this. Like, oh, apparently flip phones are back. And I had no freaking idea because that's been over forever. It turns out
not with my dad.
Well, Sweet Lou is going to enjoy this.
But he's crazy.
There's been like this bunch of celebrities who've been seen with these flip phones, including Vogue's editor-in-chief Anna Wintour.
Because they're drug dealers.
Actress Kate Beckinsale.
It's the only reason.
Rihanna.
Why you need a burner like that.
They all have these phones now. Apparently, this is a throwback for some reason. There's no actual reason. No one's ever like interviewed them to say, hey, why are you using these freaking
phones?
Right,
they're just popping up. Because they're in vogue. I get it. I understand what's happening here. I don't think they're going to come back, though. Someone from Vogue?
Yeah.
Who else?
Rihanna. She's a singer.
The only thing I can think with Rihanna is like she just needed like a one-way sort of throwaway phone with like her manager. That was a new number. You know, I mean, think about it. A lot of security issues with phones lately. Not like there's any photos taken on that thing.
Yeah, that was something that somebody over at Network World was guessing. He was like, the fappening. This is about the fappening.
Yeah.
Because you got these burner phones, you're taking photos, you're doing whatever you want with them, throw them out. Because linking your phone number and the celebrity and all this other stuff at the same time to figure it out would take way too long versus having like a dedicated iPhone that you use all the time or whatever.
Right.
But it just seems like there's no freaking way this stuff's coming back.
There's no way it's coming back, but I do sort of, you know, have a soft spot for flip phones in my heart. Like, there's nothing more satisfying than just like closing it after a call. You're like, okay, this is great. You miss that.
Why don't you just get a case for your phone that does that then?
Get out of here.
You can freaking do that.
No. Ariel, back me up. Nice okay. little like satisfaction. Click, right? You know what I mean?
I'm done with flip phones, man. I like my smartphone. I had a Motorola i90. That was fun.
Oh my God. Yeah. Look that up.
Motorola i90.
I had a look up the time port. Remember that phone?
I remember the time port.
I had one that wasn't a flip, that was just the hell do you call it? Like a little joystick in the middle of it. Let me see this. We have a picture.
So the time port up now. I get one of these. Can you identify your phone?
Which one? Yeah. I think my dad had the one on the left, the top left.
This one. Which one's the time port?
That's the time port.
But also those little two-way pagers are time ports too. I had one of those.
Oh, so time port was more of a brand.
Yeah.
There's a line.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then we have Ariel's i90. Oh, this is like the next cell
chirp
phone.
One. The are you there or where you at?
Yeah, I had one of these.
Oh, this
too.
Was a chirper.
I had the i90.
Phone. Yeah,
this was my phone before my Razer. I had a Razer phone after this.
I had that before I had my Sidekick. And then my Sidekick, I had an iPhone.
I rocked the Sidekick for a while, too.
Yeah, yeah. It was
and
fun.
Then I decided I wanted to live.
It's time to grow up.
Man, that I had the first Sidekick with the black and white.
Mm-hmm.
What a piece of shit that phone was, right?
I went through probably 8 Sidekicks because they kept breaking on me.
What the hell was wrong with the build quality of those
things? It was so bad.
So bad. Yeah, that brings me back. It's so funny now that I think about it, you know, because I make fun of my dad a lot because he's just this Luddite, but he was the first guy I knew with a cell phone, and he had a phone, and I was like, oh, man, he's so badass with his phone, and then he, like, kept it for 20 years and never upgraded.
Well, it's not like it broke. I mean, these things
Dude,
kept working.
He is rocking a Samsung. I shit you not. It's got to be from, like, 05. I'm not even joking, dude. It's insane. And he's just now, he's starting to like say, hey, maybe I'll get an iPhone.
Well, what does he want to use his phone for? My mom has a flip phone, and we slowly got her to go to the iPhone.
Right. He texts, and that's all that matters.
That's all he needs.
And it's not like he's paying less money, because they already got him for like the premium price. So he's not going to save any money. It's just this is what it is. And that's all I can say about that.
You know, it's odd. You are talking about the satisfaction of clicking the phone.
Yeah, that is nice,
shut.
Though. I missed that.
So did this. When I was looking at the story this morning, at The Guardian, this person had the same idea right here, saying, a flip phone made me, erroneously, feel important in a way that a non-flip cannot. There was nothing more satisfying than the snap of a lid.
It's so true, because especially answering it, you just hold it and be like, got to take this one. Flip it up with your thumb. Jeff here. Talk to me, you know, the Jesse from Full House answer. Talk to me.
Wow, pulling out a really old reference right
Hell
there.
Hell yeah.
I'm just thinking, like, every time they upgrade the OS, I'm like, okay, which button am I supposed to push? Right. On the screen that's changed. I'm like, is the green one? Okay, the green one's good. Okay,
exactly.
Now, is it
you
on?
You feel like a goofy bastard with touch screens. I still do.
I had a Visor phone. That was my first freaking phone. That was a PDA that had a springboard that turned into a phone. Nobody understood why the hell was carrying this giant thing.
Oh, you must have looked like such a moron.
Yes,
oh,
I did. God. I did, because I didn't make phone calls. I didn't need the damn thing for that. I used it for like data.
Yeah, but you know what? It's the same reason, you know, Jax Teller has a burner. That's, you know, illegal activity.
You think that's what's going on?
Rihanna's clearly a drug dealer.
You're saying the Vogue editor-in-chief.
Drug dealer.
Right here, seen on her flip phone.
Running guns.
You're saying that she is running guns, too.
Running guns to the Irish.
I thought the Irish were all, weren't they killed already in the sixth season? Spoiler?
Something like that.
I forget who's being shot at
these days. They're not criminals, these people. They're just trying to protect themselves. Speaking of criminal activity, though, there is a new pizza from Pizza Hut.
No, Domino's this time.
I'm sorry, from Domino's.
Don't put this evil on Pizza
that
Hut.
That might as well put people in jail.
Yeah, it's a Doritos-crusted cheese-stuffed pizza. So if you're looking at this monstrosity, this is this is exactly what it sounds like. And if you listen to the audio version, you're like, well, what would it look like? Just crumble up a bunch of Doritos and kind of like sprinkle it on the crust. That's the pizza you got there. And there's cheese stuffed in the actual pie.
I couldn't eat this.
You don't think so?
I just don't think I could stomach it. First of all, I think Doritos are the most overrated thing known to man. They are. They're just
the most really overrated thing.
Overrated snack food.
Okay. Okay.
That narrows it down.
I know. I was like, overrated thing. Yeah. That's pretty broad. Okay.
No. Yeah.
Like paper clips are pretty overrated.
Yeah. But they're still around and they're important.
Yes, and they're not on pizza.
Dorito, right? I mean, I don't like Doritos, and no one's figured out how to not make a mess of yourself.
Well, I mean, this clearly won't be messy. I mean, look at
no,
this.
No, it
this
will is, be because
no, not at all.
Because you always grab pizza and fold it like a slice, like you're supposed to.
A Domino's piece? No, a Domino's slice of pizza is about what the size of like what a trading card?
I don't know.
What do they call
it? I couldn't tell you. I've never had it.
You've never had a Domino's pizza?
No, I hadn't. It's been a while.
Well, this is not a real
problem.
No,
it's Pizza Hut Australia. You're wrong. It is Pizza Hut Australia.
Then why does it say Domino's up here and then pizza?
It doesn't. You're confusing the word Doritos for Domino's, I think.
I think you're right.
Yeah, it's the same thing.
Same thing.
That's it. Yeah.
Wonderful. This is it. Hey, partial dyslexia coming in today.
What? Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I just couldn't do it. I couldn't do it.
Yeah, you're
couldn't
right.
Couldn't eat that.
It is Pizza Hut. I'm sorry, Domino's, for saying that you had anything to do with this. You sly people at Domino's.
What flavors Doritos are they?
I don't know. I'm looking. Let's see. Crunchiest things. This is only in Australia, so you can't get it here in the States. I don't
You think Australia
either.
Just doesn't know about pizza? You think they're just like, this is what Americans are doing?
I don't know. Let's go ask Ty.
Americans.
We have an Australian that's held captive here, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got a guy. We'll ask Pendleberry.
Oh, God. Ugh. Oh, disappointing. All right. Moving right along. I am a strangely hungry, but not for that. Just strangely hungry. Just need to get that out there. This is amazing. Street Fighter V, out of nowhere, going to be a PlayStation 4 and a PC exclusive title.
Yeah, so a trailer leaked on the internet today. And in the video, they have like it's a bit of Street Fighter V, and there's a whole lot of other stuff that's going on in this video. But there's a moment where on the screen it flashes coming to PC and PlayStation 4. No mention of Xbox One, which is like insane because, I mean, if you play Street Fighter, it's like on everything. It's even on freaking iPhone at this point.
Right.
So I think I have Street Fighter 4. I have it. So like this is relatively huge. It's not confirmed by Capcom. Right? Mm. Nobody said this officially. But this trailer looks pretty official. It looks like this stuff's going to happen. Does this sound weird to you that Sony could land this?
No, because they seem to have already locked up an exclusive with Capcom already. So perhaps they are lengthening the relationship. Maybe the deal was to have a multi IP game exclusivity deal. Perhaps.
Yeah, but Street Fighter makes them a crap ton of money. Wouldn't they want that on everything?
Yeah, man. I mean, look, Tomb Raider is the new Tomb Raider is a timed exclusive with Xbox One. Maybe exclusives are coming back. I don't know. They definitely. This is a game that you would never imagine would be a console exclusive to one platform and not the other.
There it is. There's the actual things.
That's surprising.
There's
that is very surprising. Yeah. If this is real and it checks out, I mean, I can easily buy it. I can easily buy this.
Because I know around the office that it's PlayStation 4. Pretty much everyone has actually bought a PlayStation 4. Nobody seems to be on Xbox's side.
This past Black Friday was like the tipping point, and now most of the office is PS4 people.
Right, because the thing is, like, we had really cheap Xbox Ones, but no one wanted it, even though it was doing really well and people were buying it. Overall,
it did have a better Black Friday, mm-hmm. but I think the deal in terms of like the pack-in games was better for PS4.
Yeah, I mean, this thing would actually push me over the edge. Like now, actually, it's kind of like the Blu-ray HD DVD war. I'm like, okay, what's gonna happen? This one's like made it over.
Yeah,
like it's Street Fighter. I gotta play Street Fighter.
Street Fighter 4 was pretty damn good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. So this is probably a 2015 or beyond game. And that's pretty surprising news. Street Fighter.
I'll play it on my PC.
Street Fighter 5, PC and PS4 only. Remember a couple of weeks ago we talked about one of my favorite conversations in a while, a Discovery Channel show called Eaten Alive, where this putz got in some sort of suit,
mm-hmm.
and he got eaten by an anaconda.
Well, that's what his dream was.
That's what his dream was. So this is happening, and it's airing.
This freaking Sunday,
yeah.
on Discovery, Eaten Alive is going to happen at 9 o'clock, 8 Central. This isn't an ad for it so much as like if you want to watch this thing that was like protested, there was like a thing on change.org. There was a whole petition.
It just shows you how much change.org means nothing to anyone.
How many signatures it got at all.
It doesn't matter. Have you ever heard of anything successfully overturned?
Not overturned so much. I've seen White House responses. I'm totally blanking on what, though.
All right.
But are you going to watch this?
No.
Yeah, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, you're watching this.
I'll watch like the 40-second YouTube, sort of like highlight reel of it. But I'm not going to sit down on Sunday, the Lord's resting day, and just watch this. I've got better things to do.
What on earth are you going to do instead of watch half an hour, maybe hour special of this guy talking about?
It's not something I want to see, really. I want to hear if he lived or died.
I'm pretty sure
praying for one and not the other.
I mean, this has already happened. It's been recorded. Yeah, it's already done. So if he's dead, then I'm sure the ratings would be better.
Well, I can't wait for like next month's episode when they're like, now the anaconda will shit out Eaten Alive guy. And it's just going to be another groundbreaking event for the fine content over at Discovery Channel.
If this thing does well, what other things should this guy be swallowed by? What else? Like, what is Eaten Alive, the series, like? Because I'm thinking about this guy. If this does really well, he's going to be like, there must be something else to do with this because there's a market for this.
He survived being eaten by an anaconda.
See?
Now let's see if he can survive a ride through a buzzsaw. Just see, like,
it's just him
or like a wood chopper. How about
wood
that?
Chipper?
Wood chipper.
I would love that.
It's not called it's a chipper, not a chopper.
Well, you're talking, like, well, yeah, because there's chips of wood.
What's the, is that the contraption that looks like a reverse snowblower?
Yeah, kind of looks like a
snowblower. I want him to go through that and
see what
happens.
There's a show. So he's designing suits that can withstand it with certain death.
A wood chipper.
So they just keep... That's the ultimate episode, I would imagine.
Let's see if we could saw this guy in half and put him back together.
So he's not eaten alive. He'd be like chipped
He's not living dangerously enough for me just going through an anaconda.
I don't know. I mean, he was dreaming about being eaten by an animal. You got any other like living things that should be swallowing this manhole?
Can he fist fight successfully a tiger?
Can he survive going through a tiger? There is an idea.
What about a whale?
Yes!
Yeah.
A whale.
He's got to get eaten by a whale.
Clearly, we were kidding with the examples we did, but a whale is way more practical.
Yeah.
So, and there's a lot more variety there. You got killer, you got blue, sperm.
No, the big one. That's the sperm, right?
Mm-hmm. That's the giant one. Mm-hmm.
Ironic. Let's just pause on that for a second. Sperm are very small, in fact microscopic.
There you go.
Sperm whale, largest known mammal on earth.
It's oxymoron. Sperm whale.
Beard stroking worthy.
That's why we all have these. This is for the moments like this.
Yeah.
Ariel?
Well, Ariel, well, shit. I'm not sure. It's amazing.
So we got sperm whales next.
Yeah, all right. So have them get in there and document it, because I don't know why, but TV shows and entertainment has taught me that you can like live inside of a whale for a while.
Yeah, you could just have a campsite.
With a raft and like a little tent.
So you've got that. So then they also need to do like a spinoff with like little people, because they can fit into other things, right?
I can't endorse that.
You could have little people.
I can't endorse that.
Being eaten alive by smaller, large animals, like a shark.
Or people. Or like Kim.com.
Bigger people.
It's like, I'm going to live inside the mouth.
I would watch that. Little people eaten by bigger people.
What?
It would be like a live streaming of like what? It would be the closest thing we have to like live streaming pregnancy.
Yeah.
That's kind of, there
it's
you go.
It's kind of amazing.
I think everything in your mind is going back to
and
that.
And I kind of think this is the type of acquisitional program direction talent that the Discovery Channel is currently in seek of.
So they just hired a fetus.
Yeah.
Like this fetus has decided to live inside this woman for 8 or 9 months.
Right, and then they're like, oh, we can't get a fetus. There's too many legalities. What about this little person?
We're just going to... Okay. Are they going to... Are they in like a Discovery fluid? Is that what they're like floating around in?
They. My plan is to reenact every stage, every trimester.
You got a great finale there. Yep. Coming up right there. It actually writes itself. I can't wait for the confessionals. That's the thing I want to see.
And it's all like green... It's all like infrared.
You're just looking at a camera, and you're just kind of floating like this because, it's got the goop everywhere. Oh. And you just see the lower third come by. It's like inside.
There is no hell, but if there was, we are going to it.
Right now.
Hey, this is just talk. It's not like we're actually developing this. Please don't develop this, anybody.
I feel like Discovery perhaps developed something similar way more thoroughly than we just did, is what I think.
Okay, I still think little people, big people.
You can't have a show where, like, you're talking about an obese person eating a small person.
Okay,
they couldn't eat them either because that would kill them.
Living inside them is different than
eating. So it's got to be surgery.
Yeah, it's got to be placed inside.
Okay.
It's like a Tauntaun thing. I mean, you just got to sew them back up. It's okay.
Yeah, no, that's easy. Yeah, they do that kind of stuff all the time. All right. Holy moly. We got to move on. I want to get to a video voicemail, another one. See, someone sent one in, and now we got to do another one. Someone filmed a video voicemail using a custom-made drone.
Yes.
Ayaz, tell me about this, and
I'm not going to tell you anything. Blair's going to tell you. I'm going to hit play, and let's go.
Okay.
For a video made from a quadcopter. Unfortunately, it's a little too dark out right now to get some good footage, but hopefully you guys like this.
Look at this
filming
guy.
From my custom-made quadcopter that I built at school that's holding its place with GPS. Keep up the good work, guys, and I hope to see you when you break the next record. I'm going to send it up for a look around.
There he goes. Oh, wow.
This is crazy. This guy built his own drone. Was on him because of GPS. I think that's what that little light was on his microphone.
Oh, so the drone was staying in place just through a GPS signal.
Right, because he built this thing, and now we're seeing us wherever he was.
So how does that? Awesome. But how does that tell it where to stay?
Well, it might have an optical kind of recognition as well.
Look at that view, man.
Kind of like the PlayStation Move used to work, right, with the little glowing balls.
Right. That's something else. And the camera stabilization is pretty damn good.
So basically, he's topped every video voicemail ever.
Yeah. The winner.
The Blair bar's wins. Been set.
So the last one we had was like we got the awesome 404 piece of
sculptor,
art.
Sculptor, yeah.
And now we've got a drone. The other thing is he didn't just buy a drone.
He built it.
That's
pretty bad. Yeah.
That's kick-ass.
Someone else is going to have to build like something way cooler and fly that around.
Inside of something.
Yeah.
And then
swallow it and then broadcast live from it.
For the first voicemail from inside a person. No, don't do that either. Now that I said it out loud, that sounds way worse than I meant it to sound.
Let's just take that one back. Maybe you sit the next couple of plays out for this one.
All right, I'm just going to... Why don't you... got some emails or anything?
Yeah, we got emails. These are from yesterday and the day before, people wanting to chime in about 1589. Thanks to everyone, again, who reached out to us and participated in yesterday's show. It was very touching, very humbling, way more ego-stroking than we're certainly used to, right? Right?
No, I get that all the time. What do you think happens over there?
I know. Mary Ellen from Ireland wrote in and said, was just listening to 1589, wanted to say thanks for all the laughs over the years. I started listening in early 09, and I was 18 at the time, completing secondary school. You guys have been with me through all that. I listened every morning on my way to school, and you've been with me on many car journeys. I now listen to the show when I'm cleaning my place, which I got last year. Congrats, Mary Ellen. Invite us over. hopefully I'll be listening to the 404 when I head to college at the age of 24. You, Wilson, Justin, Ariel, and now of course I, as have made my different journeys throughout the last few years that much more fun, and I've often had to pull the car over because it wasn't safe to drive anymore because I'd been laughing too hard. That is so touching, Mary Ellen.
Thank you so much.
It's been great, and I look forward to checking out many more episodes of the show. Who else wrote in? We have Paul. Paul says, I'm sitting here watching your video podcast. Congrats. And I hear that this part, the video part of the 404, is coming to an end. As I prefer my video instead of audio, I will miss you guys and the guests you have, Aunt Jill, Bridget Carey, and others. Don't worry. Those people will still be around. You just won't be able to, stare at us.
I mean, they can come into the studio and try it, but it's going to be a little weird.
Probably work something out.
Yeah, just sit right there.
Good luck, and I hope you guys do another 1,589 episodes. That simply won't happen, but thank you for the well wishes. And congratulations with the baby. Yes, thank you to everyone reaching out separately, congratulating me and Stacey on the to-be birthing of our child.
You're going to have any contest like picking a name?
Nunez Bacalo.
That's the best name ever. To get just hacked to death on roll call.
I think this baby boy, which we just found out that it will be a boy, I want to crowdsource the name of this child.
Define that. Like, are people getting to choose to, like, is everyone picking, like, the first letter?
If you got a good, no, I don't care. The letters, you know, it's fine. If you have a name, I want to hear it. Because, like, you know, we have maybe a dozen in mind, you know, from Mordecai all the way to Bojangles.
Nice. Probably
Ari was like, he heard that. He's like, nice.
This other thing, this has nothing to do with anything other than your baby thing, you know, kind of important. I saw this on Daily Dot that tons of babies are being named after characters from Frozen and Game of Thrones.
Yes. So
we, are you going to go with that?
We're frequent visitors. Yeah. We're going to name it Olaf.
Olaf?
No, we're frequent visitors.
There's Olaf Bacalar right there.
There he is. He's just as pale as we expect him to be. Get out of the sun. A lot of people are naming their kids, like, you know, Archer. That's like a hugely popular name now.
Yeah, that's going to work well.
Why not? I mean, we're not going to name the kid Archer, but I appreciate its popularity in a way, although you're just naming your kid after a cartoon.
Yeah.
Not something prestigious like an astronaut.
Yeah, see, the problem is, though, I picked a guy who was alive, who's been doing some crazy shit in the past couple of years, so I should have really waited until he died.
Until his legacy is cemented.
Buzz
Aldrin's, like, really doing wacky stuff
now. I named the kid, he punches out somebody who says the moon landing was fake. I'm like, that's badass and awesome.
No, that's totally cool.
Then he did Dancing with the Stars, and I was like, Then he said some controversial stuff about global warming, and I'm like, wait, I read it? Okay, not so crazy.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah, definitely wait till somebody's dead. So, yeah, Angela's right. Make sure somebody's dead before you name anything after him, even a dog.
I think I want to name the kid Context, because I feel like that's the one thing we're losing, and I want everyone to be reminded of Context. That is, like, throughout my last 3 years at this company and just living on the internet, Context is something that has completely evaporated from the conversation.
So, and don't worry.
I want that. Don't worry. I want there to be context to live
forever. That's fantastic. So anything he says, you'd be like, that's out of context.
That's out of context.
It's out of context. Context.
I saw, so now I'm getting, like, the meme sent to me, and have you seen this one where it's like, if you're having a boy, name him Gotham?
Yes, I saw that.
Because in the middle of the night, if you roll over and look at your husband after a baby is screaming and crying, and tell your husband, honey, Gotham needs you. There's no way that guy is not going to jump out of bed and take care of Gotham, because Gotham needs him. Needs a real hero.
This is totally related, I think.
What? Oh, I must go now, Gotham.
There's the dad going for
a little experiment.
He brings together all the things. You know, he's got there's somebody living inside of him. There's a baby he's going to help.
You know, maybe we will miss the video portion of our show.
I'm going to make you miss it. I'm going to make you guys, like, what's so funny? Can't see it.
Maybe. All right. That's going to do it for us today. 866-404-CNET. That's the phone number. That is surely not going anywhere. That will exist forever. If you do send us a video voicemail, you maybe have 3 to 5 times left, because that's
probably... No, they could send it to us anyway.
Yeah, you could send it to us. We'll see it. Yeah. But that's the only people that'll see it.
It'd be, like, very personal.
We don't have a definitive date when the video shows will end, but everyone, if you do want to continue enjoying the show, if you haven't already, please subscribe now to the MP3 feed. You can either get that through a standard RSS address, which we post every day at cnet.com/the404, or simply subscribe in iTunes. Very easy to do. Whichever way you do it, just make sure you're subscribing to the audio version of the show. That's the MP3 feed. The video feeds, the standard quality, HD, HQ, all of those will just eventually go dark. So it's up to you how you want to handle that. If you want to have a little ceremony where you say a few things and you put, like, your iPod in a jar and, like, send it out to sea, I could understand a ceremony like that to say goodbye.
You could set it on fire, too, when you set it out to sea, kind of like a Viking funeral.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
So however you want to deal with it in your own personal way. But that doesn't mean we're not going to be doing video stuff. Ariel, I, as myself, we're all going to be doing plenty of video stuff for CNET down the road. Okay, I think that is it. Next week, we'll probably start the shows on Tuesday, I think. I think there's some construction that has to go down here Monday. You're not stealing my controller. Put that back. Okay? I'm on to
it
you.
It says Jeff on it.
It says Jeff on the back.
What could that mean?
I don't know.
Sorry, you're talking.
I don't know. So nice. There you have it. That's it for us this week. Thanks again for tuning in. This was a major week for us, and we appreciate all the support now, in the past, and in the future. Until next week, I'm Jeff Bacalar.
I'm Maya Zachter.
I'm Ariel Nunez.
This has been the 404 Show, high tech, low brow. We'll see you next week.